Can't hear you, man. Alas, there was an audio glitch in my on-course intro. The rest of the video was fine, it's just the intro. And it was an operator error from which I've learned, and I believe I've systematically solved for that fail going forward. What I was waxing on about was I'd welcome Guillaume back to the channel to pair for par with purpose, a format I'm exploring. It's a coopetition where we cooperate as a duo in a scramble format, together competing against the course, earning money for a worthy cause, the purpose, when we achieve par or better. It's not revolutionary. Everything under the sun is derivative in some way, and yet it still feels simultaneously freshly challenging, fun, and purposeful. The format, for those unfamiliar with a scramble format, that's each player hitting off the tee, taking the better ball of the two shots, and both hitting from there, repeating until we hole out each hole. And for every par or better we achieve together, we donate money to the charity chosen for that round. And for this pair par purpose round of 9 holes at Amsteldijk, I chose water.org. I'm already a monthly giver to this organization, and it feels an extremely worthy cause. And based on all the information that I have, a well-run crew. So deserving of a bump in largesse should Guillaume and I be fortunate, skilled, and, you know, let's say collaborative or even lucky enough to pair well and make some pars and birdies on the day. As for those, we'll donate $50 each, a possible $450 for the whole round. And we actually did pretty darn good in that regard. Watch and see. Enjoy the video.
Beauty. There you go. Sit down.
I think it's
What did you hit?
Yeah, 8, but I was afraid I...
A little short. Off we go. All right. So it's pretty wet out here today. Even though it's sunny, it's blustery. So I don't know, what would you say, how fast, the gusts? Maybe 30 kilometers an hour?
Yeah, at least, huh, I would say. Yeah, good. Gonna have to play with it, indeed.
Playing yours? So I was a bit short.
Yeah, this one, right?
Yeah. So Guillaume's got a 54, I got a 52. Get up there. Nice up. Very nice, Guillaume. Very good.
Right. Put us in the hole.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, that's nice.
I pulled it. Good distance, but pulled it.
Solo par here.
You sink this, you can go first, have the honors. It's 2 feet. There it is, very nice.
Par.
He had a natural there on that one. All right, number 2, hardest hole on the course. A muddy tee box, super muddy. Not sure what to do about that.
I would say.
Yeah, play it behind back here. Boy, that bird is really complaining there, huh? We're straight into the wind here, aren't we?
Yeah, yeah. We need a good, no pressure. We need a good t-shirt from you.
I want to try and tee it down a wee bit.
Come on, Jim.
There we go. Just a safe tee shot. Going right at the trap.
Oh, yes. Perfect.
Right at the trap.
You have a perfect one, so I can go even more aggressive. Right?
Yes, exactly. Oh, stay up, stay up. Yeah, that looks good.
Let's see.
That looks good.
To be honest, most aggressive I could go.
That was aggressive, and that was appropriately aggressive.
Well, I think you're dead center of the fairway. How do you say? You split the fairway?
Yeah, split the fairway, yeah. So we'll see. So one safe shot, another aggressive shot that could be really good. So let's see where we get. This is the number one handicap hole here at Amsteldijk. So it's always a challenging one, and the green is quite narrow front to back and very steep front to back. We got a good spot, and Guillaume's gonna go check out his, see if it is a better lie. We found it. It's maybe 35 yards to the pin. We're gonna pitch it up, put it close. Get up. Come back down.
It's not gonna do anything.
Get up, come down.
Yeah, that's better.
Nope, it's not.
It's
about the same. I think both of them have a... Okay. Well, we'll give it a go. Commit to it. Let's make it. Okay. Okay, I'm going a foot outside the cup, left outside. Tick tock. You're right.
Yeah, I don't think it's that way.
You're right. It's moving right to left. It's an optical illusion. All right, make this one. Give us a cushion. Sit, 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 sit. Oof. Oh boy. Boy, that's a lot of work still for par. Which one do you want to take? Make a decision, let's just go for it. I think maybe this one?
I think yeah. This one, yeah.
We're gonna use Guillaume's.
Fat, went so fast.
It's okay, you got it. I'd go straight at it, firm putt.
I'm gonna go right
edge. Right edge, okay.
Yeah.
That's it, no, wait, oh, it's.
Yeah, so it's definitely a little bit here. I think it's
lit where? Yeah,
okay.
Okay, here we go.
For sure, actually.
Okay, here we go. It's going in at 4 o'clock. Tick, tock.
Nice one.
Yeah.
Nice one.
Yeah. There we go.
Solid putt.
Par, par. Nice. So getting number two right on Amsteldijk is always a confidence booster. That is a challenging hole. Almost always. Okay, just one good tee shot here. Big wind coming from quartering from behind us.
Oh yeah,
we're gonna get some help on this one.
Go first again?
Sure. All right, the wind is going left to right. It's gonna definitely carry it that way, so.
So I think you should aim at those bunkers almost.
Exactly. Going just down the left side. That's the intention. I'll play. That was very short.
Yeah, but that's totally fine. That's totally fine.
It's actually rolling out here a little bit today.
So should I just try to hammer one?
Yeah, just go for it. Swing out of your shoes, Guillaume.
Oh no.
Sky ball.
Okay, yours.
Sky ball. It's in the trap. All right, so far I'm 2 for 2 in fairway and regulation. We're gonna have to cut the corner and not be too aggressive. So we gotta be smart. Wind is behind us.
I think the wind is gonna help us. I would really push an easy iron like...
Like a 7?
Yeah, Yeah, exactly, like a 7 above these two trees right
Got
now.
It, but okay.
Not something more aggressive.
Let's give it a go. I'm gonna go straight over this bunker, this little shack thing.
Yeah, a good contact, that, to be honest, that's all we need.
Yeah.
A good contact.
Get up there.
I think it's perfect.
It might be in the trap.
You think so?
Maybe. I don't think it made the fairway. It felt fat.
So you think I should...
Well, I think it's totally playable. I think you should go for it. You should just... Maybe the same thing, because even so, it's going to be...
Or do I go hybrid, very aggressive?
Oh, yeah. Let's do that.
Yeah?
I'm pretty sure I got a shot. Because even in those traps, you've been there before, I've been there before, right? Oh, good ball. It's just might fly the fairway. That was, you got all that, dude. That might be on the fairway. So two useful shots. Let's give it a go. So this is, I guess it's playable, but let's see where yours is. Yours would have been, yeah, I'll stay here. So this is 100 yards on the dot. Big stiff wind behind us. All right, this is a 100 yard shot, so let's just go for it. All right, I'm hitting a 56. Playing the wind. I pushed it a little. I wonder if that was my line. I thought the wind was going to push it this way. Oh, no.
Go with yours.
Yeah. What do you see? Downhill, right to left?
Where's the... Oh, yeah.
So I think you're right. So it's a bit uphill, and then it's a bit of a hump.
And you need to get...
So this is all speed. But it's definitely, after you get over that hump, it's going to definitely go left.
You can make your par in regulation. You can birdie.
All right, commit to it. Commit to the line. There's a little piece of grass there that I'm aiming for. Tick, tock.
Let's, come on, go, go. Oh, yes. Come on. And that's your own birdie, yeah?
That's a natural, yeah.
Please remember to like the video if you like it, and subscribe to the channel if you feel this format has some legs. It'd be great to hear what comes up for you all so we can build that together. How we might improve the format, ideas for pairings, ideas for worthy causes, ideas for potential sponsors, or whatever else comes up for you. It all starts with a little love from you all so we can pass on that love to those worthy causes.
Natural birdie. All right, we're one under after three. That's pretty good. We make a good team. Here we go. Aiming for between the pin and the right side of the green. Nice, easy 6-iron. I think it rolled off the back. That's interesting. I mean, I definitely pulled it, but the wind really pushed it. We need that. That's not a safe shot, so I think we need a safe shot from you. What are you gonna hit?
A 5, but I don't have.
Beauty, perfect. Draw right in there. Draw in there, baby. Sit down, sit down. Ho, 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 ho. All righty.
Keep on going, we keep on going.
Oh, that was perfect. That's it. You just lag it, good to go.
That was right where I aimed it, so I'm a bit almost frustrated it didn't.
You mean that it didn't draw in more and the wind didn't help it?
I really thought the wind would help it at all.
But you said you have a natural fade, so weren't they, you know, they were competing with each other, right?
Yeah, but I actually had a pretty good fade.
That was a draw one, yeah, from the start.
Yeah. Well, good for us.
Yeah, right? So this is too much club. It's one club too many. Theoretically, I could have got here with my seven given the wind, but we're gonna play Guillaume's there. It's on the fringe. Good spot. Wow, that wind is something else, right? I see a little left to right, but I wouldn't even give it away. I'd go right at it probably. The green is going that way, so it might take it a little. Get up, get up.
Oh wow, that's get up. So bad.
It bumped a lot though, it bumped a lot. All you right, see it bumping?
Yeah, but.
So what did it do? Did it move left to right? It didn't?
I think you can go almost straight at it.
Okay. I'm gonna go in between the camera and the hole.
Just go straight at it.
All right, I'm gonna do what Guillaume said. I'm gonna go straight at it. Tick, tock.
Ah, that's much better. Nice.
Oh. Not much better. Yeah, no, we left ourselves a bit. I should have been more aggressive about that.
Good luck to us.
I'm gonna go left half of the cup. Tick, tock. Wow.
It actually moved the other way around, unless you pulled it.
No, I think it moved. That is.
I didn't want to be in that position.
I'm so sorry about that.
Actually, I think it's the other way around.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think it's going to come down.
Yeah, I didn't know until you put
it. I misread it, so it's definitely going to break.
I would have said the same as
right to left.
Yeah.
But maybe just one ball out or right edge. You seem to be lined up a little left there, for what it's worth.
Yeah, good one.
We want this par.
No, you're right.
There you go. Get in there. Yes! Oh my god, that was clutch.
Good that you told me to.
Yeah, right?
To reset. Nice
well
one.
Done, bro.
Whoa.
Well done.
Not good. A little bit relieved.
That was clutch, clutch, clutch.
Nice one.
We're going to keep on scoring. That was super fun. So
yeah.
We're really supporting each other. Well done. So we've just been reflecting that if the rhythm is good, is that when one of us makes a mistake, the other one picks up the slack and. That's what you want in a scramble partner.
Oh.
And so we're one under after four, and we're giving some money to water.org. 50 bucks a hole. Water.org provides safe drinking water to millions of people around the globe. That's their mission. And you know, in Maslow's hierarchy, water, it's way up there.
It's kooky that access to natural, fresh, clean water is not a basic human right. That is, I mean, every human. My personal opinion is that fresh, clean water is one of those very few things, the handful of things that should be exempted from capitalistic dynamics. There are, as I said, a handful of others, but that's for another context and video. And what does that mean, exempted from capitalistic dynamics? It means that fresh, clean water should be accessible to all and not subject to profit, shareholder pressures, regional monopolization of water rights, or real-life Chinatown-like larceny. It's a good movie, by the way. Highly recommended if you're a Jack Nicholson fan. Given that fresh, clean water is literally the font of life, one of the critical foundations from which we survive and thrive, it kind of feels like it's best instantiated as a global commons. And whether or not that ever happens, in the meantime, water.org is helping the every person, truly. Their mission is to empower families living in poverty with lasting access to safe water and the hope, health, and opportunity that that brings. And they've already done so for tens of millions of humans across the planet. And those humans were either harvesting water from unsafe sources or paying exorbitant fees from vendors that sometimes behave extractively. I mean, some of these families were paying 20% of their income just to stay alive. I mean, it's nuts. So water.org has co-opted capitalism to help provide extremely inexpensive financing for the every person to enable them to implement safe water and sanitation into their communities and their homes. I mean, this is a step in the right direction. Check out their website for some impressively impactful stories, and please show them a few bucks of love if you're so inclined. For what it's worth, they don't know we're doing this video, and I do not represent them in any way, beyond the evangelical support that is intrinsic. Enjoy the rest of the video. More holes to come and money to be earned to donate to water.org.
Okay, on number five, a very birdieable par five. But we just want to do one shot at a time, just one at a time. Go, 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 you got to run, no wind help there. Oh man, that might be water. I mean, it went a good way, so it could have gone over, but it's really risky. Beauty. Perfect. Perfect. Very safe. Look at that. You moved your butt. That was your athleticism at work there, because you were making adjustments, micro adjustments to the very end there. Yeah, but you pulled it off, and you saved us on the tee. So I might have a great shot, and it may not have gone far enough, so we'll take a look. All right, he found my ball. Didn't go that far, but mine was in the rough.
It would have been playable.
It would have been playable? But this is highly playable, so why don't I put one down the fairway safe and you go for it? How about that? Well, I don't know about safe, but I'm gonna put one down the fairway, just a nice easy six, and then you can go for it.
Oh yeah, that's perfect.
It's not very far, but
no,
safe.
No, but that's exactly what we need.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, we'll be about 100 out, something like that. Oh, it's drawn a bit. Uh-oh. Sit down. Oh, you're safe.
Yeah, but yours every
playable.
That's a bit of a waste, but
it's all right.
I know that I had my face closed when I was at the
place. Oh, you did?
I should have changed it. I don't know why I didn't correct it.
It's all right. We're safe.
Where you get and adjust.
Exactly. I'm aiming for the right side of the green. It's safe to the right, you know, less safe to the left. So I'm going right at that big tree in the distance.
Okay. Yes, come back. Oh,
stay up, stay up. Too much club.
What did you hit?
Eight.
Too much?
Well, I mean, maybe it's, I don't know. I mean, I can't tell if it's pin high, but it's not a brutal amount of. But I would normally hit this, if I hit it well, and I hit that pretty square, 150, 155. Come around, come around. It's good, it's good, it's good. So I'm down there, and that's a lot of uphill. It's in the saddle, but I think Guillaume's is the one to take here. They're about the same distance.
What do you see? I see dead straight.
I see, almost if anything, a little right to left, but I would go straight at it. Let me look at the grain. Grain's going this way, so if anything, it's gonna go right to left at the end. Yeah, see, I see right to left. Good putt.
Oh,
too short. That was a good line, right?
Yeah, but.
And you went right to left, right?
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, the line is, you're correct. I mean, it's probably one cup outside or
like. Tick tock.
Nice.
Wow, it broke way more.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, sorry.
It's okay. Tick tock. Oh shit.
Ooh, where are you?
Right here. Dude, I f***ed it up, sorry. On the top of it. No, the top right here. There you go. Ooh. Okay, I was getting a little cocky there. That was lame. So no more cockiness. Not if.
You can have a bit more freedom if I hit a good one.
Not if. When. Beauty. Beautiful spot. Beautiful spot. Beautiful spot.
I didn't see it, to be honest.
I said it three times. It's straight. You split that trap.
Okay.
You split that trap. It was perfect. It's perfect. Yep, I'm going at that left bunker.
Yeah, just go as aggressive.
I'm in the rough though. You're in the fairway. That would have played just fine. All right, this is where we could start to get a lapse in concentration. We're on hole 6, par 4. We're 1 under, so we need to buckle down. So we're gonna play. Yom's, his was here and mine was right, plugged right in there. So there, so we were right next to each other and he's got a very good line to the green. It's, so there's a stiff left to right, shows 143. Right on the pin, be the right club, be the right club. That was good. If the distance was good, that was perfect. What'd you hit there?
7, as smooth as possible. But
yeah.
You can basically, you always have one club less than me, at least. So you can, if I hit a 7, you can hit a 8.
That's what I'm gonna try. I think Guillaume just gave us a birdie look, a legit birdie look.
I hope it really, how do you say, stayed there.
Yeah. Oh no, totally chunked that. Wow, that's one of those big misses. Okay, you put us in excellent position. That's what, 10 foot, maybe 8
yeah,
foot?
Probably.
And I chunked it. Question is, would it be playable? It would be plugged, if anything, if it didn't splash. I found it. Totally playable right here. Not a great spot, but totally playable. I have the confidence in you, but I'll get my putter, but I'm not going to take it out of the sheath. Good putt. No. Well, that's a...
We have the par. Go ahead.
We have the par. Well done. All right. This for bird.
Turned a little bit, huh?
Turned left to right. A cup left?
Yeah, I would say at least. That's, I mean, I finished, what, 2 cups almost?
Got it. Commit to it. Tick, tock.
Oh, yes. Come on. Oh, no. Oh, no. You left it short. Okay, we have the par, but this was the perfect line.
Oh, well. That was a missed opportunity. Yeah, I know.
Totally figured out.
It was a bit uphill. I didn't play it for the uphill. All good. Another par.
We're not gonna cry on a par.
Number 6 is a par. Right, that was almost that was a natural par though for you, right? And here we go. This is a par 3, number 7. The wind is in our face, yeah. And quartering, so it's gonna play long.
And pushing towards the water. Huh?
Exactly, and pushing towards the water. Let's ask the robot. The robot says 153 into the wind, so it's going to play what?
Do you want to go first?
160-ish. Yeah, I'm happy to go first.
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm just wondering if if my 7 is enough, because my 7 would normally be between 150 and 160, 170.
It should be enough, your 7, yeah. Yeah, I think it should be enough.
Oh boy. I got scared of the water. That was the right club though. All right, nice easy stroke. Stay up. Stay there. Stay. Oh my goodness, that's gonna be, I think it's okay, but it's gonna be a question mark.
We're happy about the strike, the stroke. But I hit it, but really underestimated the wind.
Yeah. Well, that was a natural draw and it just accentuated it, but I think you're okay.
First yours at least. Let's see where you...
Should we take a look?
The bunker. Okay.
Oh, it's just here, yeah. That's tough though, short-sighted.
We need to go over.
Yeah, with water in the back, that is not an easy shot.
No. Oh yeah, it's there, it's plugged.
I knew it. So this is the one we're playing. All right, that's a good spot. All right, just throw it close. Get up there. That was a little too much loft.
It's a shot. Yeah, you see the tee. Oh man.
Yeah, I see it. It's okay.
Very, very
it's okay. This is hard to sweep.
Yeah.
Very hard to sweep.
Ah, oh, nice one. Perfect. Ah, beauty. Okay. You can.
Now I want you to do the honors.
No, you go.
Right there. Tick tock. All right. Pulled off a par there. Okay, that's the think box. Now play. Oh no, 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 no. Like you said. Better than mine. Yeah, but it's kind of near mine, isn't it?
I think we've been in better position.
Yeah, that's okay. That would be a real challenge if the pin was way in the back.
Yeah.
But here, it's not as big a challenge.
Yeah, it's true.
So we'll have a shot at the pin. That shows 164 now from where I'm standing. All right, out of the rough, I'm gonna hit my six, give it an extra club. Oh, come on. What am I doing? Just went right past this tree. I totally chunked it. That'll work. Sit down. Kick right. It's okay. We'll go up and down.
That's not the best.
We'll go. No, it's all good. That was a weird lie. Confused me. All right, so this is the first hole we've been in a wee spot of trouble.
How much do you have?
45 yards, 44.
That's
right, kick right.
That's good.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, we have a chance.
Yep, we do. Oh, Jim.
Go.
No.
Yeah.
It's terrible. Grain looks like going left to right. Downhill. Yeah, the grain's gonna take it this way at the end. Downhill.
Yeah.
Left to right.
I feel like it's gonna go this way.
It may, but the grain is going that way. So I would go straight at the cup, frankly. Did it break?
No, it's...
You pushed it?
Terrible, but...
You pushed it. Tick, tock. Oh, come on! That broke right and then left.
And then left, yeah.
Unbelievable.
Oh, that's painful.
That is annoying. That's right, we're still at par. So we had that buffer.
Yeah,
and we spent that buffer on number eight. Final hole, pin placement is back center. The wind is stiff in our face, maybe a little left to right, and it's showing 136, playing more like, I would say, 150.
Yards,
yeah. So that'd be 125-ish.
150, okay.
Yards, so it'd be 135 meters.
Okay.
I think that's about right. Perfect, right on the pin. No, it's good. Be the right distance. Be the right distance. Perfect. It's a little short.
Yeah.
What did you hit?
7, but I hit it way too up in the air.
No, it's fading.
Dry.
That didn't even make the green, did it? And I see some uphill. And the green is moving away from us, a little to the right. Shouldn't be a huge factor. Go, go, go! Go, go, go!
I'm not putting them. It's crazy. I don't have them.
It's okay. Did it break, Guillaume?
A little bit.
To the right?
Yeah.
All right. It's uphill. Got to give it a go. Tick, tock.
Perfect. Oh, and I felt like you hammered it and it was perfect.
That's because there was that much uphill.
Finish it off.
I think you should finish it off.
Just in case, but...
Tick, tock. So I'm saying, I don't know what's going on. I've got the yips. Let me try that again. I'm giving you the chance to play into the... I got the yips for some reason. It's weird. Tick, tock. Oh my God, that's so weird. All right, dude.
We did it.
We did it. Guillaume Legu and Jim Bannister just parred. Scramble. I mean, it's an impressive thing for us, but maybe not for others, that we collaborated to par our home course of Amsteldijk. And I'm quite certain we can do better than par if we ever decide to give this a go again. And that means we had 8 par or better. Is that right?
Par
or better.
Pars, one birdie, one bogey.
That means $400 goes to water.org. Thanks for helping the world with clean water. It's a high priority. Guillaume?
Nice fun.
That was super fun.
Yeah, that was a lot of fun.
Good teammate, good collaboration. Until next time.